Media queries are a fantastic feature in CSS that completely transformed the way we write style sheets quite a while ago. Today, it still seems that not many people understand that you can actually nest media queries. So in this video, I will show you how, and I will even show you how you can nest media queries directly within a selector if you're using Sass. And lastly, I will show you how to use variables within media query feature expressions. Well, you can't use them right now because it's not supported in browsers, but you will be able to use it fairly soon. Let's dive in. As always, I have a demo here on CodePen to demonstrate how this works. And let's create a simple media query, media screen, so we know it applies in our case. And let's set background to our list elements right here. And we're gonna do background Rebecca purple. And as you can see, this is applied to our list items right here. And now we can nest another media query directly inside of this one. For example, if we do media minimum width, and let's do 1 pixel just so we know it will apply. Let's set background to red. And as you can see, this works. And this works in native CSS. And as I'm here using the Sass syntax, let's just try to quickly switch it to no preprocessors, just so we can demonstrate that it actually works. And as you can see, it works. If we increase this to maybe 10,000 pixels minimum width, you're gonna see that this is not applied, only this part of code here is applied. All right, and next thing I wanna show you is, and this applies only to Sass, is that you can actually nest a media query directly within the selector. And Sass will know exactly how to compile that. And that way you can actually avoid duplicating your selectors. So let's see this. If we have our selector LIA with the background of Rebecca purple, and if we nest media query right here, again, minimum width of 1 pixel, we're gonna set background to red. And you're gonna see that this is not applied because I haven't switched to SCSS syntax. So let's do that. Let's turn on our Sass preprocessor. And now it actually works. It means that we can nest media queries directly within our selectors in Sass. It can be really helpful because it can help you, as I mentioned, avoid duplicating CSS selectors. You can also nest media queries within supports rules. So let's try this, supports at rule. And I have another tutorial on supports at rule, and you're gonna find a link on the screen and in the description if you wanna check exactly how supports at rule works. And for now, let's just do supports. We're gonna test if the browser supports, for example, display block property, the value of block. And if it does, we're gonna apply Rebecca purple to our list item background right here. And as you can see, this has been applied. And here we can nest again a media query. And we're gonna do another minimum width of 1 pixel just so we know it will apply. And we're gonna switch this to, in this case, let's do blue. And I'm missing the selector here, so let's add our selector right here. And you're gonna see that this is applied right now. And this works in native CSS as well. So let's turn off our preprocessor right here. We'll set it to none. And let's see if it's still applied. And sure enough, it is. You can nest media queries, supports, at rules on any number of levels and any combinations. So you can create quite complex logic using that. But one thing that we still can do in media queries is use custom properties or CSS variables directly within media query parameters. And that way you could set certain variables, certain screen sizes at one place in your code, and then reuse those throughout the code without having to repeat those exact numbers that you used. So we would do something like root, and we'd create the custom property of small, maybe device screen size small, with the value of, I don't know, let's say 500 pixels. And now, ideally, we wanna use this in our media query, minimum width variable of small. And here we would apply whatever it is we wanna apply. Let's do Rebecca purple again. As you will see, this doesn't work. And the reason for that is because media query is resolved on document level, let's say, and our CSS custom property has to be defined on an element, like on a root element here, on HTML or any other element. So this basically is out of scope, and that's why small is not going to be applied. And just as well, it's not going to work if we create entire media query in our variable right here. If we were to write something like this, small is going to be minimum width of 500 pixels. And again, this is not going to work. There is a solution for this though that's coming to browsers fairly soon, and that solution is called Add Custom Media. Add Custom Media works pretty much the same as Custom Properties, but it applies to media queries. So we would use it directly in our code like this, Add Custom Media. This is the variable that we want to use, maybe a small device. And this is a media query that we want to apply for that particular custom media. And in that case, we would use it in our media query just like that. So I'm switching this to Rebecca Purple just so we can see that this really isn't applied, because Add Custom Media, unfortunately, is still not supported in any of the browsers. If you want to use it before it's available, you can use it as a PostCSS plugin. And that plugin is going to be PostCSS Custom Media that allows you to use custom media exactly as we've shown in our demo here. And once it becomes supported, you will be able to use it natively. And this is it for this quick tip. In short, you can nest media queries any level you want to create complex queries, to create complex structures. You can nest them within the supports at rule. And if you're using Sass, you can also nest media queries directly within your selectors. And that can be really helpful and useful to avoid repeating selectors in your code. You just write a media query directly within your selector, like we have right here, and it works. Sass knows exactly how to compile that to a valid CSS. Thank you for your attention. I hope you found this helpful. My name is Zoran Jambor. Hit that subscribe button and I will see and hear you in the next video.